Shalom, you're watching Arutz Sheva TV. I'm Yoni Kapinski, and this is our daily edition. The IDF is preparing for a possible resumption of rocket attacks on Monday evening. As the current five-day ceasefire is set to expire, the ceasefire is set to expire at midnight, but Hamas has been known to violate truces before they officially expire. The high alert from Monday evening comes in the wake of estimates of diplomatic sources in Jerusalem that the chances of lasting ceasefire deal with Hamas before Monday night are very slim. Around 10,000 Israelis poured into downtown Tel Aviv Thursday night. They called on the government and the army to end Palestinian rocket attacks from Gaza once and for all. It was the first major demonstration in Israel since the country went to war against Hamas on July 8th, launching a punishing air campaign followed by a ground offensive designed to stop rocket attacks and destroy attack tunnels. Organizers said the rally united people across Israel's often bitter divides of left and right, as well as religious and secular. Alon Davidi, mayor of the southern town of Sderot, told the rally there must be a solution, be it political or military, to 14 years of rocket attacks. Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu opened the weekly cabinet meeting, emphasizing that Israel will not compromise on its security in any deal with the Hamas and the Palestinian Authority.
המשלחת הישראלית לקהיר פועלת מיומה הראשון תחת הנחיה ברורה מאוד לעמוד בתוקף על צורכי הביטחון של מדינת ישראל. רק אם יהיה מענה ברור לצרכים הביטחוניים שלנו, רק אז נסכים להגיע להבנות. בחודש האחרון החמאס ספג מכה צבאית קשה. אנחנו השמדנו לו את מערך המנהרות שהוא חפר במשך שנים, פגענו במאות מחבלים, הרקנו את הרקטות שהוא צבר במטרה לבצע אלפי פגיעות קטלניות בעורף הישראלי, וסיכלנו את הפיגועים שהוא ניסה לבצע נגד אזרחי ישראל מן הים, מן האוויר ומן היבשה. אנחנו עם חזק, אנחנו עם נחוש, ראינו את זה בגילויים מדהימים של עוצמות וחוסן בשבועות האחרונים, הן אצל החיילים והן אצל האזרחים. אנחנו נמשיך לעמוד יחד איתנים ומלוכדים עד שנשיג את יעדי המערכה, השבת השקט והביטחון לכל אזרחי ישראל.
Hundreds of protesters arrived at Rishon LeZion near a wedding hall there. The Lahava activists were demonstrating against the mixed marriage, the intermarriage of a young couple from Yafo, Moral, a 23-year-old Jewish woman, and Mahmoud Mansour, a 26-year-old Muslim Arab. A counter-protest also took place nearby. We met both sides.
Intermarriage is something that destroyed Judaism, all generation, destroyed Judaism in the exile. It's coming into the land of Israel. We have to stop it in the beginning before it becomes something that we cannot stop.
This is not just a wedding. This is a Jewish neshama. This is one of our people. This is a Jewish soul that's been stolen from the Jewish people. And she's been pulled over, and we're in pain. And we're saying, how can a terrible thing like this happen? It's like we lost another one in the Holocaust. It's like another one of the 6 million. And if only she knew. And I'm sure her parents are in pain. I know her father for sure is in pain. This is just not how we live. This is not according to the Torah, and this is not what a Jew should do.
What's the goal of a protest like this? I don't believe you're trying to convince her to come out and say, I regret.
Well, we never give up on any Jew, but we want to give a message to others to think about it. It's not legitimate, it's against Judaism, and we're not going to hug them if they're doing it.
I think it's been water under the bridge already. I'm not really sure of all the details, but what I can say is that it's our job as Jews to look out for our sisters, to look out for their souls, to look out for their lives, because I really want to tell all you girls out there that think that some Arab is going to come and give you a better life, you're totally going to suffer the rest of your life. So please be careful.
You came here as a counter-protest to the Lahava protest.
Yes, I came here to show another voice. I don't support intermarriage. As a religious Jew, it is sad for me that as someone chose that she didn't feel like Judaism was so important to her. So it is something which is sad for me. I wish that the world was a different place, but this is not, the wedding is not the time to come and tell her what she should believe. As a religious Jew, I'm embarrassed of being of the Leva organization. I think they're acting out of racism. If it was important for them, assimilation, they would be spending the effort in education.
Those who say this is not democratic, let any person do whatever they want.
That's more democratic than anything else. Why is it democratic to come and protest against me buying a house in Hebron, and it's not democratic for me to prevent a Jew from committing suicide? Well, this is against assimilation. We don't like our enemy, but that's not the goal of this demonstration. We are against assimilation.
9 years after she was expelled from her home in Nezer Chazani in Gush Katif, in the block of Jewish settlements in the Gaza Strip, Anita Tucker speaks with Arutz 7 in a full interview about the feeling, about the thoughts 9 years later, about the will to return home. As we can see here, Anita also referred to the feelings as she knew, she met the soldiers who actually came, reached the lands which were once the Jewish communities of the Gaza Strip, Gush Katif.
All of a sudden, after a long wait, they see the soldiers coming out, all dusty and tired, and they're looking up at the signs and they're saying, Netzer Chazani, what are you doing here? Netzer Chazani, what are you doing here? And when the people can't understand why they're getting so excited that it says Netzer Chazani, and all of a sudden they say, we just were on the ruins, we just walked on the ruins of Netzer Chazani. How could it be that just you are here waiting for us? What an amazing thing. And they started crying, and they were hugging the youth and the ladies, and everybody was standing there crying, and there was a feeling that we were closer to going back home than ever before. In addition, I can tell you another story. I went to visit the Hadar Golding family, because the Kala, the fiance, was from Ganeital. And I asked her, had she spoken to her fiancé about having been in the near Ganeital, near where she came from? And he told her that yes, he was in Rafiach, and he could see in the distance where the yeshuvim of, where the towns of Gush Katif had been. And her feeling was very close also, that perhaps in the future she and her fiancé would be able to live in Ganeital. Unfortunately, he was killed fighting to defend, again, the same area that so many soldiers have died defending over and over again.
The city of Netanya, the World Zionist Organization, and the Ministry of Absorption held a special fair today about immigration, absorption, and real estate. The main target audience, the French Olim, the French immigrants who arrived in Netanya and arrived to other places around Israel. In wake of the anti-Semitism, there is another rise in terms of the Aliyah from France. They come from Zionism, but also there is the issue of anti-Semitism.
Absolutely. I think if you look at history, Zionism was always, and Aliyah was always the draw, you know, of Israel, Zionism. But there's always a push. Always a push from behind. Sometimes it's anti-Semitism, sometimes it's economy. Sometimes, not like in France, it's both. So, yeah, sure, anti-Semitism there, the economy problems are there. But Israel is here waiting for them, and I think although there's a problem in anti-Semitism in France, if you ask any Olé why is the reason he's here, he said, what do you mean? This is my home. Israel is my home.
Okay, that'll be all for today's Daily Edition. Until next time, from all of us here at Arutz 7, IsraelNationalNews.com, Shalom.